Coming to the variation. Variation means, now as we considered factors which influences the electrolytic conductance. We studied four factors: nature of the electrolyte added, okay, size of the ion producer and its solvation. Third, we said about nature of the solvent and its viscosity. And fourth, we considered temperature. Four major factors we considered. Now, variation of specific conductance, or I can say conductivity with the dilution, which means how specific conductance changes if we change the concentration of a electrolytic solution. Means we can increase the concentration of a electrolytic solution, or even we can decrease the concentration of a electrolytic solution. If concentration changes, how specific conductance varies, how it changes. So here, now we have, if I consider nature of electrolyte, we have weak and strong electrolyte. So solution of both, solution of weak electrolyte as well as solution of a strong electrolyte, in both cases what happens, that a specific conductivity always decreases with the decrease in concentration. So specific conductance, what we said, the conducting power of all the ions produced, the conducting power of all the ions produced, or I can say present in between two electrodes of having unit length and unit area of cross section. Now here, when you think of analogy, say there will be two electrodes, between we have placed a solution, both the electrodes are of unit length and area of cross section, unit area of cross section. And dilution, what happens in case of specific conductance? If a dilution means we are decreasing the concentration. So on dilution, the number of ions, I am going to say, please make it clear, the number of ions per unit area, per unit area of cross section decreases. So I repeat, on dilution, the number of ions present in this area, that is unit area, goes on decreases. If number of ions decreases, what happens? Conductivity decreases. So we say specific conductance, specific conductance, that is conductivity of both weak as well as strong electrolyte, always decreases with the decrease in the concentration. If you decrease the concentration, specific conductance always decreases, irrespective of nature of electrolyte. It may be solution of weak electrolyte, or it may be solution of a strong electrolyte. As number of ions per unit area decreases, hence that conductivity also decreases. So what is the reason I quoted here? On dilution, number of ions per unit volume, as we said, unit length and unit area of cross section. So overall, what I can say, unit volume. So the number of ions per unit volume decreases, hence conductivity also decreases. Okay, they may ask in the form of reason, how specific conductivity varies with the dilution. What is the answer? Decreases. Okay, what is the reason here? On dilution, number of ions and dilution number of ions per unit volume decreases, hence conductivity also decreases. Okay, well, coming to the variation of molar conductance, or I can say molar conductivity with the dilution. So both are different, specific conductance conductivity kappa, molar conductance lambda m. Okay, now we are looking for variation of lambda m, that is molar conductance, or I can say molar conductivity. Well, in general, what we said, molar conductivity of an electrolyte increases on dilution. It increases on dilution. Well, how or why it increases? Generally, when you look at the relation, lambda m is equal to kappa into v. We have this relation, that is molar conductivity or molar conductance is equal to product of conductivity and volume of a solution. In the previous slides, we have gone through this. So lambda n is equal to kappa into v. If specific conductivity is kept constant, what is the relation? Lambda m is directly proportional to v. And dilution means what we are doing? We are increasing the solvent concentration, that is volume goes on increases. So if volume increases, molar conductance also increases. So generally what we said, in general, molar conductivity of an electrolyte increases on dilution. This is because a dilution volume containing 1 mole of electrolyte increases based on this equation. Okay, both are directly related. So we are saying as volume increases, so molar conductivity should increase. So generally both are directly related. So we say molar conductivity increases on dilution. But when you think of variation with respect to as like a weak and strong electrolyte, it is totally different in this case. Molar conductivity of strong and weak electrolyte differs. So coming to the variation for strong electrolyte, say we have a solution of a strong electrolyte. Now in this case, how molar conductivity of a solution varies on dilution. So in case of solution of a strong electrolyte, what happens? Molar conductivity increases slowly with the dilution. Means when you increase on dilution, what happens? Molar conductivity goes on increases. In which case of strong electrolyte, to what extent? Well, here to what extent increases? It increases till concentration approaches to certain limiting value. Means when you go on decreasing the concentration, say when it approaches a certain limiting value, till that there will be increase in the molar conductance. Okay, as we said here, the strong, in case of strong electrolyte, molar conductivity increases slowly with the dilution and approaches a limiting value when the concentration approaches to zero, which means till when on infinite dilution, when concentration approaches to zero, till that the molar conductivity, or I can say molar conductance, goes on increases. This is because decrease in the inter-ionic interaction. So what is the simple reason here? In case of solution of a strong electrolyte, with on dilution, molar conductivity goes on increases. What is the reason? Due to decrease in the inter-ionic interaction. Okay, well, the molar conductivity of an electrolyte. Now we analyzed here, so when concentration decreases, molar conductivity goes on increases. To what extent? Till concentration approaches to zero. Okay, so according to this concept, what I can say, the molar conductivity of an electrolyte, okay, when the concentration approaches to zero. Now we are looking for the molar conductivity of that electrolyte when concentration is almost zero, or I can say at infinite dilution. That molar conductivity is considered as a limiting molar conductivity. So I repeat, what is the limiting molar conductivity? It is the molar conductivity itself when concentration approaches to zero. So what you have specified here, lambda m is nothing but lambda naught m itself. Molar conductivity, lambda naught m, it is the limiting molar conductivity. So molar conductivity of an electrolyte when concentration approaches to zero is called limiting molar conductivity. Okay, how it is denoted? It is denoted by a symbol lambda naught m. That is, lambda m is equal to lambda naught m when concentration approaches to zero, or else we can say at infinite dilution. Now this variation, the variation of molar conductivity with concentration, is given by this expression. Well, what is this expression? It is called Debye-Huckel-Onsager equation. Okay, what is the equation? It is Debye-Huckel-Onsager equation. This equation holds good. What it holds good? It holds good variation of molar conductivity with the concentration. For what type of electrolyte? For strong electrolyte. So for variation of molar conductivity of a strong electrolyte with the dilution is given by, that relation can be given by Debye-Huckel-Onsager equation. Okay, so what is that equation? Lambda m is equal to lambda naught m minus a into root c. or I can say Z raised to 1 by 2. Okay, so it is the Debye-Heckel-Ohm-Sagar equation. So this equation is compared with equation of a straight line, that is y is equal to mx plus c. So according to that, we are going to get coordinates here, that is lambda m and root c. If you plot a graph of lambda m versus root c, what we get? We are going to get a straight line with intercept is equal to lambda naught m and slope is equal to minus a. So this equation holds good for strong electrolyte. Okay, so graphically, when you look at the graph of lambda m versus molar concentration root c, for strong electrolyte, what we say, when concentration decreases, molar conductivity goes on increases. To what extent? Till concentration approaches to zero. At this point, what happens? Molar conductivity itself becomes the limiting molar conductivity. As we defined it, molar conductivity of a solution when concentration approaches to zero. So it is called limiting molar conductivity, which means graphically, with the help of Debye-Heckel-Ohm-Sagar equation, if you plot a graph of molar conductance versus concentration, we get a straight line with the intercept is equal to lambda naught m. So this quantity indicates the intercept. It gives the lambda naught m, that is limiting molar conductivity, and slope of the straight line. If you plot a slope, if you calculate the slope, which gives the constant, that is a. Okay, well, coming to the variation of molar conductance of a weak electrolyte, whether they follow Debye-Heckel-Ohm-Sagar equation or not. No, for weak electrolyte, what happens? On dilution, conductivity increases gradually. So in case of weak electrolyte, say acetic acid is a weak electrolyte, here what happens? When you decrease the concentration, say towards the origin, when you decrease the concentration, molar conductivity goes on increases. Okay, but when concentration approaches to zero, what happens here? In case of weak electrolyte, there is a sudden rise in the molar conductivity, which means when concentration approaches to zero, a weak electrolyte start acting as a strong electrolyte. Therefore, there is a sudden rise, a steep rise in its molar conductivity. As there is steep rise, that line do not intercept the y-axis. If it do not intercept, then you won't get a limiting molar conductivity. So we can say, for weak electrolytes, the limiting molar conductivity, it is not possible to calculate with the help of Debye-Heckel-Ohm-Sagar expression or equation. So what is the explanation? On dilution, molar conductivity increases gradually due to increase in the degree of dissociation. But what happens as concentration approaches to zero, or I can say at infinite dilution, weak electrolyte undergo complete dissociation and produces large number of ions. It leads to steep rise in the molar conductivity, and thus limiting molar conductivity cannot be obtained by extrapolation of a curve. So is the drawback of that Debye-Heckel-Ohm-Sagar expression. So what is the statement? Therefore, limiting molar conductivity of a weak electrolyte cannot be calculated by which expression? Debye-Heckel-Ohm-Sagar expression, or I can say graphical method. To overcome this difficulty, a scientist named Coleridge, he gave some law named as Coleridge's law. With the help of Coleridge's law, it is possible to calculate the lambda naught of a weak electrolyte. Okay, I hope you understood. In the next session, we discuss about Coleridge's law and how we determine the lambda naught of a weak electrolyte and its application part. Okay, thank you.